One of the most common questions about PowerPoint is how to add animations. In this first video of my three-part series, I will cover the fundamentals of animation, like showing the different types and how to add a basic animation. Once you have the fundamentals down, moving on to intermediate and advanced animations will be much easier. Hey everyone, I'm Jennifer Sharkey, presentation and public speaking consultant. Let's get started. Before you begin applying animation in PowerPoint, it helps to know how they are categorized and how these categories affect the function of the animation. These categories or types are also referred to as effects. The first effect category is Enter. With this animation, objects are not visible initially and then appear based on a specific action by the presenter, like a click of the mouse. The second effect category is emphasis. Here, an object is visible on the slide and will animate to draw attention to it, such as pulse. The third effect category is exit. Here, an object is visible on the slide and then will exit from view based on an action like a mouse click. The fourth effect category is motion path. With this animation, an object will move in a certain way on the slide, like one from one location to another. To apply an animation on a slide, you need at least one object on the slide. An object is any type of content that can be added to a slide, such as a shape, text, icon, picture, etc. In this example, I will use a shape on a blank slide. The location of the object will be where the animation either ends or begins. You want to select the object, click the Animations tab, and click the animation that you want to apply. You can scroll through the gallery or click the small drop-down arrow to display more options all at once. When you select an animation, the object will show what the animation looks like. You can also use the preview button on the Animations tab to see what the animation looks like. You'll notice that the object now has a small box with a number next to it. That is a visual indicator noting an animation has been applied to the object. The number indicates the order the animations occur if you have more than one object animating on the slide. In Windows, if you select a new animation from the gallery, it will override the previous selection. For instance, if I apply an emphasis animation, the Enter fly-in is replaced. The same with applying an exit fly-out, the emphasis effect is replaced. To remove an animation, just choose None in the gallery. In video 2 of this 3-part series, I will show you how to apply 2 or more animations to an object. Some animations, like fly-in, are preset to animate from a specific direction. To change the direction, click the Effects Option button after applying the animation. From the drop-down options, choose the direction you want. If the Effects option isn't active, then that effect that you selected can't be changed in any way. The next effect I want to touch on is the motion path option. You can choose a basic effect like moving in a straight line or something highly custom like drawing your own path. With the motion path, the small green dot is the starting point and the red dot is the ending location. To extend the path, you can drag and drop the red dot to a new spot on the slide. With the motion path, the animation possibilities are quite extensive, especially if you use it with other effects. If you have several objects that you want to add animation to, here are some strategies I use to save time. If you want to animate multiples of the same object in the same way, first add the shape, then add the animation to that shape, and then press Ctrl+D to duplicate that shape. Rearrange as needed, and you will notice that all of the objects have a number indicator next to them. The different numbers indicate the order the objects will animate. Let's click the preview button to see what it looks like. Copying the shape and pasting is another option, either on the same slide or on another slide. To copy, either use Ctrl+C, right-click and copy, or the copy button in the Home tab. Then paste using either Ctrl+V, right click and paste, or the paste button in the home tab. Just like with duplicate, there is an indication number. If you want the same object to animate on a different slide, you can duplicate the slide. Select the slide in the thumbnail, pressing Ctrl D or right click and choose duplicate. Looking at the second slide, you can see that the object has an animation indicator. I will change the object's color so we can see what it looks like. I'll go into presentation mode, and here's what the animation looks like. If you have several different objects and you want them all to have the same animation, you have a couple of options. You can select all of them and click the animation type in the animations tab. You will see that they all have the same animation indicator next to them. As the preview shows, this option sets the animation for all objects to start at the same time. You can also use the animation painter. Once you've added an animation to an object, select it, click the animations painter button, then click the next object you want to apply that animation to. With this option, it sets the animations to start one after the other. If you double-click the painter option, you can apply the animation to multiple objects without having to click the painter button for each object. And in part two of this video animation series, I will cover intermediate features like timing, adding multiple animations to one object, and how to best leverage the animation pane. I'll also show you how to use an on-click trigger.